Just because a person is a wheelchair user does not mean that you can't travel and enjoy the world together. I have 5 tips for part 1 of this series of traveling with someone who happens to be a wheelchair user. Hello everyone, I'm so happy to have you here. I'm Lisa Chappell, I'm a doctor of nursing practice, a registered nurse, a professor, and a coach. I'm also a mother and a wife of a wonderful man who happens to be a quadriplegic. I make videos for nurses, students, and caregivers on how to become more resilient and empowered. I have 5 tips for you in this series, which is all about traveling with someone who is a wheelchair user. If you're looking to plan a trip or will be traveling with someone who is a wheelchair user, then these tips will help you make that trip more enjoyable. My husband, who is a C6 quadriplegic, paralyzed from the chest down, and I have traveled thousands of miles together. We've been on Alaskan cruises. We've flown to Hawaii. We've driven to the Florida Keys. We've traveled with a caravan of Mini Coopers across the United States, from Atlanta, Georgia, all the way to Thermal, California. We have taken excursions on buses, catamarans, boats, and land cruisers. So we've been able to travel and really enjoy the world together. And we have a ton of fun. That brings me to my first 5 tips. Tip number 1 is to dream it together. If there were no barriers, what would you do? Where would you go? Do you want a sweet tropical getaway where you can relax and enjoy some warm sun? Or do you want to sail the ocean blue and explore some cool glaciers in, say, Alaska? Would you like a road trip together to visit some family? Or do you just want to escape to the mountains for a weekend? Whatever your desires, discuss it with the person you want to come along for the adventure. Ask where they've always wanted to go. I suggest focusing on the future travel and adventures rather than somewhere that either of you have been before, because you're going to be building new memories. Okay, so now that you have a concept of your ideal getaway, this brings me to tip number 2, reconnaissance. You're going to do some research and find options that are accessible to someone in a wheelchair. This means finding accessible accommodations, potential activities in the area that you might want to visit. The burden should not fall entirely on the person who is a wheelchair user, nor should they have to adapt around activities that you or other able-bodied people choose. For example, if you want to eat at this great restaurant that gets amazing reviews, but then you arrive and there's no tables that can accommodate a wheelchair because maybe they're all bar height, and your travel partner then has to look up into everyone's noses, or the tables are too low and they can't get their chair up to the table or even under the table, or it's a really old building and your travel partner has to access the building behind the dumpsters and then take a rickety elevator from the kitchen. This will result in frustration for everyone involved, and it makes for no fun when traveling. We want fun. That's the goal, and it is possible, but it requires a little bit of planning. Research hotels that are known for accessibility. My husband and I typically stay at the Marriott. This video is not sponsored by the Marriott, but they have a guaranteed roll-in shower policy, at least when we book the room, and he can get a shower during our stay. No shower, again, equals no fun. And we want fun. My third tip is to adjust your expectations. This trip is not for you and your extreme sports adventure buddies. This is an inclusive trip that is meant to be fun for everyone. Just as you don't want to be made the target of attention and humiliation, neither does your wheelchair-using partner. Don't plan activities that will just result in frustration. This is not the time to book a zipline extravaganza or a glacier ice canoe tour, unless it's something that you both dreamed about in tip number 1, dream it together, and you've planned it to a T with necessary helpers and equipment that is needed with experienced adaptive activity guide. If this was more for the able-bodied adventurers and it wasn't dreamed about by your differently abled travel partner, then skip it. However, with some planning and creativity, you can still plan some pretty fun and amazing things. The world is becoming more accessible for everyone, but it also still has a long way to go. Pay attention to activities, restaurants, and hotels that address accessibility with that little blue man symbol. This is your key that there was at least some attention paid to the accessibility. That brings me to tip number 4, which is be creative and innovative. Focus on what you can do together instead of being frustrated by what you can't do. And if you and your travel partner dreamed about it in step number 1, think about how you can make it a reality. For years, when my husband and I traveled, we felt frustrated that there was certain terrain that he couldn't maneuver with his manual wheelchair. Gravel or dirt hiking trails were incredibly frustrating because he would get stuck by the smaller wheels in the front of his chair. These wheels are called casters, and they're great for helping with steering, but not so great for navigating rougher terrain. That's when we discovered a device called the freewheel. This is an attachment that we did need to measure and custom order for his chair, but it was so worth it. It attaches to the front of the chair, lifting the casters ever so slightly above the ground and making for a really cool three-wheeler that suddenly can be pushed around on more terrain. We have even been hiking in the Sonoran Desert recently with this. What can you think of that can help you and your travel partner overcome barriers to travel? Please comment below. We would love to hear about your idea. That brings me to my 5th tip, and stay tuned for 5 more tips in my next video. My 5th tip is to have a sense of humor. When traveling with someone who is a wheelchair user, you're bound to run into obstacles. People who aren't educated about equity and inclusion of people with physical disabilities and who just don't understand or make assumptions. And things will happen that really make you think, what just happened? It is really important to then just roll with it with your differently abled travel partner. Laugh about the ridiculousness of it later. Mostly, my husband and I like to travel in our Mini Coopers, but we also have a van. Her name is Vanna. She is the truck in the family. Well, one time we decided to go see a movie, and there were no accessible Blue Man parking spaces left at the theater. These spaces are necessary for the extra room provided by the hashtag with a side access ramp so that you have enough room so that a ramp can extend and a wheelchair can have enough clearance to go up the ramp. Well, that day we just went ahead and parked in the back of the parking lot in the boonies, way out in the back. And we parked across 2 spaces, sort of hoping that no one would decide to park next to us. Well, as we went back out to the parking lot, we were laughing about the movie we just saw, and we absentmindedly clicked the remote on the key fob to open the ramp. And then we watched in horror as it opened directly underneath the Jeep that was parked directly next to the van. Now we had a situation with a van that has no driver's seat because it is outfitted so my husband can drive it from his wheelchair with a ramp jammed underneath a Jeep. Suddenly, the good vibes from the movie were gone, and we were in a bit of a pickle. Eventually, after a lot of creative thinking, aside from alerting the whole theater for the Jeep driver to come move his vehicle, I was able to drive standing up and angle the van enough that the ramp had some clearance to come back into the van, and then I could get out into the aisle of the lot so that my husband could get back in the driver's seat. We had to just have a good laugh at the ridiculousness of the situation. A sense of humor can do wonders to making light of challenging situation. This may be well after the event, granted, but a spirit of adventure and some lighthearted humor when reflecting on your travel experiences can do wonders for bonding and making you more likely to want to go and have another adventure together. Able-bodied caregivers or nurses and your wonderful wheelchair-using travel partner. Please like and subscribe. Comment below, and I will see you soon for part 2 of this series for the next 5 tips for traveling with someone who is a wheelchair user.